Good morning, everyone. So I tried doing some steelhead fishing a couple days ago in open water, and that did not go very well. So now I'm back on the ice doing some ice fishing with Nick again, and hopefully we can get on some nice fish. We have four tip-ups set up right now. We just got all set up, and we're hoping for some nice fish hopefully some pike, maybe some walleye, and then we're gonna jig for some bluegill, panfish, really whatever bites actually. So we're looking forward to it. We have the whole day to go fishing, so hopefully we can get on a few fish, and hopefully I'll meet you guys at the first flag. Yeah, the line's pulled behind us.
What's up?
Okay, just after I shot the intro, got the first flag, just on cue. That's perfect. We had a little sucker on here, so let's get the fish. It's a good time. We've only been here for about, I don't know, 45 minutes. Oh, no, that was nothing.
Nothing?
Well, I ripped the sucker off. That's perfect. Oh. Okay, we got our second flag. We're not sure if it's a fish or not. Oh, I think it's the fish. He was taking out, like, really fast runs.
Okay.
But it's a big sucker, so I'm a little nervous here. Don't want to set the hook and lose the whole sucker.
Taking line, though?
It was taking line when I got here, but it was a big sucker, too,
that's
so... If I set it, yeah, I don't think it's a fish. I'm good. Yeah, I don't know, those might be tooth marks.
Yeah.
On the top, he's got a little beat up. Okay, so it's been a pretty slow morning so far. We've not gotten anything in about 2 hours. So right now what I'm doing is checking all the tip-ups and making sure there's still minnows on there and that they're active and lively and swimming around, that kind of thing. I always like, you know, minnows that are moving around, fighting around a lot, because I think that draws fish in quicker. And let's see, this shiner looks pretty dead, so it's a pretty small shiner. We've been getting some flags, but I think lots of them have been walleye that are like grabbing it and dropping it right away, or just the minnow itself is setting the flag off, because we've gotten flags, but none of them have had fish there once we get to them. So I'm thinking either it's a mix of the minnow setting it off and, you know, maybe walleye dropping it right away. So either way, I think these fish are not very active, so we're going to jump these tip-ups around to the different holes. We've had this one sitting here for about an hour and a half, and so we're going to move it around to a different hole, maybe let it sit there for an hour, and if we don't get any bites there, we'll move it again and just kind of keep jumping around, because sometimes these fish are sitting around and not moving very much, and when they're not moving, you have to move to them sometimes. So hopefully that's the case, and we can find some fish in a different area. So we're not giving up quite yet. We're going to keep jumping around and hopefully find some nice walleye or maybe some pike. Okay, we got another flag, finally. I was just saying how we haven't gotten one in a while, and now we finally got one here. It was just running, so we're hoping there's still a fish on here. There we go.
How's she feeling, bud?
I don't know. Not that big. Yep, little pike.
Yeah?
Yep.
Hey.
First fish, though. We had to start somewhere.
We were struggling there for a sec. Got something.
This is the typical pike you get out of here. Hey, stop. I'm trying not to get you on the ice. You should thank me. There we go. Well, that's not quite what we're looking for. The right species, but not the right size for sure. Just a little gator, real skinny, nothing very big. Kind of your typical pike from here, like I said, so... Let's get right back down the hole and hopefully get his mom. Come on. Okay, well, that was a pretty bad release, but either way, he
must be tired. He needs a nap.
Yep. He went down. Let's get some bigger ones. Okay, we just changed spots and Nick hooked up on the jigging rod.
Kind of feels like a pike, maybe. Not quite sure. Come on.
How far down is he?
Not sure.
This little spoon?
Yeah.
Oh. Is that really
sweet? If it was a walleye, please be a walleye.
Big ol' walleye, nice 9-pounder.
Here it comes.
I'm gonna say bass.
It's bass.
Oh, perfect.
I'll take that, nice. Baby. That's the first legit jigging rod fish this year, dude. Heck yeah, that's a nice bass, healthy bass. Yeah, that's
good chunky largemouth.
Better than the little two inch perch I've been trying to jig up all day. Heck yeah, I'll take that any day. Yeah, that's, that's a nice little football right there. Okay, that could have gone way better, but still, I'm glad we switched spots. All right, let's get it going.
So windy. Let's see if we got fish on this flag. Pretty frozen to the ground. Is it? Oh yeah, it is a fish. I thought that was a, or no, it might not be. What the heck?
It's gotta be.
No, I think it's stuck in the ice or something.
What?
I have no idea, I'm so confused right now. It doesn't feel like, there's spurts where it doesn't feel like you got it. No, it is a tiny fish, I think.
Yeah, maybe a walleye?
Little bass.
Little bass? Uh-oh.
Come here, dude.
Okay, turn it into a bass segment, Josh?
Yeah, this is what we waited for 4 hours for. Little 12-inch bass.
Better than nothing.
That's true. Well, like Nick said, better than nothing. Let's get him back down the hole before he freezes.
Dude, we were struggling on the releases today.
Well, as you guys saw, it was a pretty tough day out on the ice for us. We did catch a few other fish that were not in the video, but it was pretty windy during certain points of the day, so sometimes the audio was not very good. Either way, we still had a good time out there. Lots of people here in Michigan have not been able to go ice fishing yet, so I'm happy just to be able to get out and, you know, catch a few fish on the ice. We were fishing one of the largest inland lakes in Michigan, so it's very possible there were hungry fish somewhere. We just weren't in the right spots, but either way, I really appreciate you guys sticking around, watching these videos, even on the slower days. It means a lot to me. I always appreciate any feedback you guys have for me, and of course, I'll catch you next time.